Hi guys, welcome to Scale Model Headquarters. In this video, I'm going to scratch build one hell of a scale model. Polish Volkin battleship WPK-1 Hussar. WPK stands for Wojenny Pułap Skoczacki, which according to Google Translate means war rolling vehicle. My inspiration was this amazing painting by Jakub Rożalski. I'm going to walk you through the process of making it. I started off with drawing it on paper to figure out how I want it to look like, because the painting wasn't detailed enough. Then I calculated how big it should be. I found out it should be roughly 40 cm tall, so I ignored it because it just wouldn't fit into my shelf. I ended up making it 25 cm high. With a ton of enthusiasm, I started building it. First thing I made was the front section with windows and interior. For the front section I used 1 mm styrene sheet from Evergreen. I heated it up in hot water and shaped it on a spray can. I used a razor saw to cut out the actual windows. The interior was made using seats and instrument panels from my spare parts box. Then I attached the sides, ceiling and a catwalk. I made an engine cover for the rear and added few vents to it. The mesh on the vents is a net from a toy parachute, simply super glued on. After that I started making the lower part of the main hull. It was a necessity to make some supports for the curve underneath the catwalk, to make it sturdier. I glued it all together and used some plastic card for the top, front and rear sections. Humbrol model filler was used to fill in the gaps. I let it dry for 24 hours and started sanding it down. After I sanded it down, I used flat black color made by Agama to show any imperfections. Luckily there weren't any and I could move to the next step, which was making the hanger for TKS Nanket. I added some details to make it more interesting, such as the door, some wiring, a poster and a lift for TKS on the ceiling. For that I used 4 mm I-beams and 3 mm rod from Evergreen. I tried to find something that would look like a steel rope in 72nd scale. Surprisingly, ordinary sewing thread looks just like a small steel rope. I cut out a locking mechanism from my old Churchill from Tamiya and used that to attach the upper superstructure to the hanger. Also I used a lid from a Pringles can to cover it all up. For the lower part of the legs, I used 7 and 4 mm I-beams from Evergreen. The rest is 1 mm styrene sheet. I wanted to be able to dismount a wall model from whatever base it would be mounted on. So I cut out those weird shapes from the bottom of the feet, glued it to the rest, and this is how the mechanism works. After that, I painted the legs in flat black and added few details. The pistons were made inserting 4 mm rod into 5 mm tube. Then I just added hydraulic tubing and some straps. I decided to add a rounded front to the hanger, so I patched the windows up, applied a lot of filler, sanded it down and sprayed it with flat black. Attaching the feet to the rest of the legs is what followed. Then I made a frame for the bottom of the hanger out of 4 mm I-beams. and here is the finished frame. I made a fuel tank out of a plastic bottle and two beer can bottoms. The rack for it was made out of 4mm I-beam. Then I started making the rivets. For that, I used 0.8mm styrene rod cut to small pieces. I applied them using a special tool made out of an old disposable pen with a needle instead of a normal end. As a glue, I used Tamiya extraction cement. I tried using Mr. Cement S2, but it dries way too quickly, thus making it unsuitable for that purpose. I used the same technique on the wall model. Later, and please don't call me a rivet counter, I counted the rivets. There is exactly 2971 of them. Then I cut 0.8mm balsa wood into 2x40mm pieces and glued those to a sheet of paper with PVA glue. I painted it with oil paints and blended the colors together using white spirits. I have a video about that on my channel. I drilled holes into the balsa wood to help me fix railings I made earlier in place. And here is the hussar before primer. At least that's what I thought. Later that day, I spotted small cracks right under the line of rivets on the top of the upper superstructure. They are really tiny, but I couldn't leave them there. So I filled the cracks with Citadel liquid green stuff, which is dilutable with water. I applied it on with an old brush, let it dry for 5 minutes, put water on it and wipe it off with a cotton bud. Unfortunately, it requires a couple of layers to fully fill the crack in because it shrinks while drying, so it took a while. I decided to add a lift to the underside of the hanger. So I cut the shape of it from a 0.5mm styrene sheet and glued on the frame, which was made out of 4mm I-beam. We'll be right back. After I finished the frame, I made an anti-slip surface on the floor. I used a razor saw to scribe it in. After that, I could make the railing. For that, I used 0.8mm styrene rod and copper wire of the same thickness. I needed to make it stronger. That's why I cut out some straps to hold it in place. I added a few more details and that was the lift finished. After that, I sprayed it with Tamiya Fine Surface Primer, let it dry for 24 hours and then I started with pre-shading. Once the pre-shading was done, I started painting it with highly diluted field green.
Thank you.
that's painting and decaling done. After that, I sealed it with Revel Clear Varnish and started making some scratches with lighter shade of the base coat. Then I made a wash out of oil paints and applied that to the rivets to make them pop up a bit more. I applied dots of burnt umber under the rivet heads and, using downward strokes and a flat brush slightly dampened in white spirits, I dragged the paint down. I glued on a Polish army bow force from First to Fight and some resin figures from Cyber Miniatures I painted earlier, and the Hussar was, after 9 months and more than 600 hours, finished. So I hope you enjoyed this video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!